by the religious leader in charge of the temple, saying, "How dare you carry your mat on a day like this?" And the man replied, "The man who cured me said to me, 'Take up your mat and go.'" And what he has seen is declared is that you cannot terminate what God has done in my life. And I am saying, this is the kind of grace I am praying God for your life. This is more. No man will terminate what God has done in your life. No man will terminate what God has done in your life. No demon will terminate what God has done in your life. No demon will terminate what God is doing in your family. Yes, I pray that we Tell the little God how to do this for our children. And give him glory as his talent on this blessed day, on this month of June. No one, no man, no woman, God or woman will take the little to have from me. Lord, whatever man may have succeeded yesterday, I receive the grace to begin to triumph over them.
Thank you.
Let them laugh at us. Let them mock us. One thing we have come to know.
Because God is God.
Father, things like that for your children this month, that they will come to know that you are God. Let the power of your grace flow over their lives, that they will have the conviction in their hearts that no matter what, you are still God. Even if the sun refuses to shine, you are still God. Even if the storm is empty, you are still God. I thank you. And I ask that this altar will speak for your children. This altar of sacrifice will speak for your children. For the blood the evil ones have shed, let this altar rise against them. For the evil leaders that have dominated us, let this altar rise against them. For those who have treated us to the powers of darkness, let this altar rise against them. From the sanctuary to the deep, let this altar rise against them. Because you are God. By the sacrifice of Jesus, in which he said, it is finished. This is this moment. You shall find grace to end your shame. By this sacrifice, you will find the exceptional grace that will bring an end to the battle against you. The enemies that are written against you that you are a failure, the grace of this moment shall wipe out that handwriting from your life. The enemies that are pronounced that you will not make it, that your children will not succeed, that your husband or your wife will never succeed, you will find grace to wipe that handwriting. Sacrifice for you. Whether what is going on in your life was done by your ancestors, whether they made a sacrifice that has traded you to demons, whether or whether those who hated you traded you without your permission,
us. There shall be a release.
Mosquitoes.
He did say, will you not drive it away? He said, will you not kill it? I thank you, Lord. May every evil power site feeding on your glory, feeding on your life, feeding on your resources, feeding on your health, feeding on your finances, feeding on your children. Let the consuming fire of the Holy Ghost begin to consume them and ashes. In the name of Jesus, I will lift upon every parasite, Holy Ghost, in the name of Jesus. This is your exceptional month. May the power of the grace to be released for this month not pass you by. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Blessing upon your life and blessing upon your destiny. Amen. In Jesus' holy name we pray. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace and peace of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, the Lord of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. I want us to, at this moment, bow our heads and tell the Lord we are sorry for whatever mistakes we have made or our children have made that has given the enemies of our hand and traded us away. We want to say, Lord, we are sorry. When they brought the woman caught in adultery to Jesus and they said, it is written, she must die. And Jesus looked on the ground and said, say nothing. He looked at each of them and said, if any of you have not seen before, be the first to cast a stone. And one by one, they all left. Your mistakes will not be the reason the enemy will have up our hand over you. And that's why I say, let's tell the Lord we are sorry. By the grace of His mercy, even if it has been written that you must die and be condemned, there is a grace that can wipe away every handwriting. Ask for that grace, the mercy of that grace upon your life, your children, your family. And the Master said to the woman, I will not condemn you. Go and sin no more. Together we say the act of contrition, oh my God, because you're so good, I'm very sorry that I have sinned against you. And by the help of your grace, I will not sin again. Your mighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting. No, today we saw grace and justice. I pray for every one of you born this month that God's blessing will rest upon your life. I pray for all of you gathered here today that the power of God will minister to your need.
because you are here. Because you are connected to this gathering, the precious Eucharistic Jesus will speak grace for your life. Let us pray. Oh God, through the falling of the cross, you wondrously taught St. Justin the matter, the surpassing knowledge of Jesus Christ. Grant us this knowledge, and that through his intercession, that having rejected deception and error, we may become steadfast in the faith. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God,
yeah.
God is God. I say God is God. Whether the devil likes it or not, God is God. In good time or bad time, God is God. Whether it's true or good time, God is God. Can I hear someone shouting again? God is God. Amen. This is what I want you to settle in your heart, in your mind, in your spirit, that God is God. Your deliverance comes to perfection when you come to the conviction that God is God. When God first heard the cry of the people of Israel while they were in bondage, of course, at a point in time, they forgot the God that was their God. May this never be our story.
Amen.
Can I hear you say, I will not go back to where God brought me out from? Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
But now, when a wicked the people suffer. When the wicked heart steps into a place, there's going to be confusion. The fruits of wickedness is the suffering and pain many go through. 90% of the suffering and pain that humans go through are the result of the wickedness and evil of their hearts. But I want those who have found God, because where your support and strength will come from, where your strength will flow from, where your courage will always be renewed from, is in the heart that knows that God is still God. There were still some faithful people among the Israelites who still held on to the revelation of the God of their father, Abraham, Isaac, Jacob. There were still some in Israel, even in the land of their captivity, that told themselves, we will not bow to the gods of Egypt. There were still some, even while they were living in the midst of their enemies, who still reminded themselves that they are not yet where God wants them to be. It was the cry of these people that God heard. If there are people who will stand the gap in these days of troubles and tribulations, crises, wars, starvation, the shaking of war, killings everywhere, if there are people that will still stand in the gap, it must be people who have. There must be people who have come to the conviction that God is still God. Their heart is unshaken. Their minds untroubled. Their faith undisturbed. Their love for God is unwavering. Why? Because there was still the conviction in their spirit, God is still God. When these people cried in prayer to the Lord of heaven and earth, He looked for a man that still has a conviction to deliver the message, His message to the people. He found Moses. Moses was tested when he saw an Egyptian and an Israelite fighting. It was a test of conviction and commitment. Moses was living in the house of Pharaoh, enjoying the food of kings, wearing the clothes of a prince, as if forgotten his foundation, as if forgotten where he began from, what he was taught. It was a test. And I am saying that every one of us will be tested. If you still know God is God, in the times of troubles, in the times of tribulations, in times of afflictions, in times of crisis, in times of pain, in times of uncertainties, when life is coming upside down, can someone still hold in his or her heart, God is God? When a man passes the test of the divine, he's promoted to become a vessel for the kingdom. And no man will survive unless he understands deeply inside that my troubles, my pains, my delays, my anxiety cannot take away from me that God is still God. And Moses passed the test. How did he pass the test? He stood on the side of the oppressed. He stood on the side of God's own. That is something that any man needs to understand in life. Whatever is, whatever is happening to you, stand on the side of God and stand for those who stand for God. Moses took the risk. Truly, it can be a risk when a man chooses to hold on to God above all others. This is the anger of those who hate the ways of God. This is the anger of those who despise God. And that's why there will be people that will never be happy with you when you love the ways of God. Because they know that by loving the ways of God, you must never accept the ways of men, the ways of evil, the ways that are wrong. So they know that you will not be a party to their conspiracy. You will not be a party to their evil gossiping. You will not be a party to their wicked plots to bring down another person. Because of that, they will be angry with you. They will hate you. They will fight you. But in all of this, there is one thing you must stand upon. One thing you must continue to remind yourself. upon the throne, who sees what eyes cannot see, who alone knows the right time to step in and get his children out into freedom again. God is still God.
Hallelujah.
And Moses killed the Egyptian. He was ready and willing to sacrifice his position as a prince to be the prince of the Most High God. This is something you must make up in your mind. The world may offer you things that will control you and drag you into their company. And I'm saying to you, make up your mind which side you are. The promises of men are nothing compared to the promises of the living God. Moses ran for his life. But it was then God found him and called him. And he said, I have heard the cry of my people. I have seen the affliction. I have seen how their slave masters have treated them. And I have come down to deliver them. Hallelujah. Try of God. If you think that God does not see what you go through in your life, tell the devil you are a liar. If you think that God does not know what you are passing through, tell that devil you are a liar. You cannot blackmail God. You cannot debase God that I know. There is nothing you are going to tell me about God. All these lies you are sowing into me, making me to think, making me to ponder. Listen to me, devil. God. Without weapons of war, without chariots and charioteers, without bows and arrows, without spear or javelins, God brought out a people from the clutches of their enemy. Can I hear someone say, God is still God? I want us to remain in this conviction. That's why we will see what we hear, what is happening around us. God is the God, and God is going to have the last stage. God will have the last stage in the events of man, not the enemy, not the evil ones. So if you are going to be standing, then you must continue to stand with God, because God is the God. And when God led them out, and somehow, for those of you who have visited the Holy Land, you will discover that Israel wasn't far from Egypt. Those who have visited the Holy Land, when they took you to Egypt, to Mount Sinai, you didn't go on with air. They took you in bus. They drove. It means that it is also trackable. If they go in bus, it probably will take you about 7 hours. So it's almost like Benin to Abuja. Yes. How come the Israelites spent 40 years to get to their promised land? Why? And this is something I want you to know. For many of us, can also be the reason for the delays. The delays for our lives, yes, we can also be the cause. A journey that could take 40 days they tread because they were crowded. So they will not be walking fast. Just moving, resting, sleeping. They can use 40 days. A 40 days journey became a 40 years journey. Something was wrong.
And what was wrong? Because those men and women who left the land of Egypt are yet to dissociate themselves from Egypt. You cannot carry what is of old into the new. Jesus said, if you put a new wine into an old skin, what happened? It will burst. If you sew a new cloth with the old one, it will tear. This was the problem of the Israelites. They were yet to come to tell in their hearts that God was in God.
That is the reason why many of us and many people will continue to remain the way they are. Roaming around their testimony. Just going around. Their testimony is so close, but they are just going around. Because why? Inside of them, they are yet to accept the conviction that God is God.
We are many Christians, many people who go to church and they say they worship God, but they still don't believe in their heart
that God is still God.
That is the reason why we go round and round and round, and why many could not get to the promised land, because they refuse to come to text inside of them that God is God.
If you are going to get to your promised land and get to the fulfillment of God for your life, settle it once and for all that God is still God. Can I hear someone shout it?
God is still God.
No wonder why the Israelites were in Egypt. What happened when they couldn't see Moses anymore? The one that was leading them. They said to Aaron, come.
Mark for us the God like that of Egypt.
And they brought out their gold earrings, their jewelries, the things God gave them free of charge. When he told them when they were about to leave Egypt, he said, look, go to the Egyptians. Anything you ask them, they will give you.
God gave them such an amazing grace. Everything they said to the Egyptians, give me this, they'll say, take it. Give me that one, take it. Give me, they will even ask, what more do you want?
And now, what God gave them freely, they turned it to make a God like that of Egypt.
And you could see that their minds were yet to be cut off from Egypt. For any time they get into trouble, any time they face problem, what do they say? Please, let's go back to Egypt, where we eat cucumber.
May God not let us enjoy the food of our enemies at the expense of losing sight of a greater blessing. Amen. And why so many of them died in the wilderness? Because their hearts were yet to be made up. You must make up your mind and remind yourself that God has brought you out to know Him. There is no going back. When you listen to the story of the man Tobias today, wonderful story, you need to go and read it. You need to go and read that portion of the Bible, the book of Tobit. You will find it in Catholic edition of the Bible, or any Bible that has the apocryphal books is there. Go and read the entire book of Tobit. It will strengthen your faith. Tobias was a man who loved God, worshiped God, and would not mess up with God. After the day's job, it says it was hot, so he decided to lie down outside to take fresh air. And he didn't know that there was a sparrow. And then the sparrow dropped his mess and it went straight into the eyes of Tobias. He said it was hot. And he said every treatment he got makes it worse until when right. But despite this trouble, Tobias did not give up on God. That's why it's good to be a good man and to train your home to be good. Blessed is the family that has built up their life in God. May the Lord be your strength and your shield. You must become a generation of blessing. Because I'm telling you, God will not forsake those who love Him. Be generation of blessing. At different points, I have encountered situations dealing with people. You see that? The father is evil, mother evil, children evil, and if there be any one child that will say, I cannot follow your ways, they will torment that child. Because he has failed to join them. Generation of evil. Child of God, God will see God in all of this. I was ministering to this young lady who haven't done the assignment at this dream of seeing a white snake. And I was wondering, is there anything like white snake? I don't know. Maybe there are white snakes. But this was a white snake. So while she was talking, I was asking the Holy Spirit inside me, there must be something about this white snake. What is it, Lord? And he said, I'm going to show you. The white snake is simply a representation in that dream of a pretender. This person may be close, but is a serpent. So, when she finished narrating her story, the Lord said, we are going back there. And we went back there. And when we got there, during our dreams, she cut off the head of the snake. But when they cut off the head of the snake, the head of the snake became the head of a human being. So she was telling the other person, say, strike the head, strike the head. That was how she was. Pray and bring up your family to know God. Don't compromise your faith, not for everything. Just like Tobit. But let me finish this. Now, when we went back and we got to that same place, it was where they were living before. So we got back there. And then I asked her to ask the person behind her, which was a neighbor, family friend, where is the head of that snake? As they were asking, I saw this lady started crying. Why was she crying? The person she saw. Ah, now you, family friend, people they were living in the same neighborhood. Now you, what have I done to deserve this? And he said, not only you are good people, they happen to. And look at you. You have a good husband. Even when we try all our best to make started talking different things. And then we said, let's go to your cobbles. And they all went. In that cobble, the father was there. The mother of that person was there. The two sisters were there. A brother was there. Oh my God. Generation of people. You just have a whole family dedicated to eating. This is the reality of life. This is the reality. And at the end, they said, this lady, they said, that the one that blocks you, why you can never have more. We stop this, we did this, we got that. But you know what? In his time, he makes all things beautiful. Oh, when you show up, you make my life so beautiful. Children of God, evil may be real, but God is still God. And it will take us, the children of God, to get to understand and build our knowledge and our faith to fight and defeat these evils. They are everywhere, and I mean everywhere. So, eventually, God took up the battle, fought the battle, and Mother Mary said, keep praying your rosary. Go and succeed. Go and succeed. I was ministering to somebody in UK on phone during the weekend who had been sick and happy. She was fine when she left Nigeria and then stayed with this family. As soon as she got into that home, life started going down. Nobody knew when this was coming. And they were dreading her to pray. They were dreading her to pray. Yes. They were the evil. But you see, nothing a man can hide from God. Nothing. Nothing under the sun. When God chooses to reveal, it cannot be hidden. The truth is, these evil people will never accept their evil. That's why they will perish in their evil. Some of you are here now, you know you are evil. You won't accept. You go accept. No, 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 they don't accept. But that's worse for you. But for God's sake, why not make up your mind who you want to save? Why using church and God to pretend? I'm telling you, nobody, evil does not respect titles. Bishop, pastor, prince, sisters can be possessed, including you. No demon of, that respect any title. The only thing demons will respect in your life is when in your heart there is a conviction that God is still God. Some time ago, I don't know if it was this year or late last year, I shared it with you of a young man who called, and the wife was admitted because she had very high BP, and the doctor said they have to remove the child now. I don't know if you remember that story. And I said, we will come back and tell you. And the young man said, I will not take any decision until I seek the counsel of my spiritual director. The doctor said, look, this is a terrible case. This woman, we have to remove this child now. And that evening he called and said, Father, look out. And I was sharing with the wife what happened. The Lord said, ask her her dream. When she couldn't remember any dream at all, but when we prayed, she remembered, and the Lord said, that's it. And when we decided to pray and go into the realm of the spirit, when we got there, they told her that there is nothing any doctor or medicine can do to bring down your baby. Because the more she was taking drugs, the higher the baby was going. The Lord fought the battle, destroyed the enemies, and she came in touch with heaven. And heaven said, go, you will deliver safely like the Hebrew women. The young man just told me yesterday, said, Father, my wife has given birth. That was what the doctor said, it cannot happen. Look, I am simply saying that no matter the evil that exists, God is still God. I saw a priest and a lady that brought the priest yesterday. And she was sharing with me what an encounter, and that's why you see, be careful. Yes, the day she came praying for blessing of the woman, she reminded me what I told her. I didn't even remember. I said, go to Mother Mary. I said, go and listen to her. Whatever she tells you, come and tell me. She said she went and she shared what she said. I said, go home as well. And at that point, she was pregnant. Now, when we prayed, she saw one of her mother-in-law, one of her another person, and the sister of someone. And in the course of the battle, she destroyed them. And she was telling me, we never spoke after that. But just that yesterday, she was telling me, Father, do you know, two of them that I struck with the sword died. The one I caught on the leg that escaped, she's suffering. Whatever that happened to her leg, she fell and broke her leg, and she's still there. But you see, the problem she had was that because people are too scared and afraid, God does something, you are still looking for someone. And she said she went to one woman that was having adoration somewhere. That one priest said, I'm going to that woman. But she didn't know. And when she got there, in that place, she lost her baby. Look, I have said it many times. No God. And don't jump anywhere. Because everybody loves you. Are you hearing me? There are many people who use God to cover face. You've got to trust this God. Because he's the power to save your life. So children of God, there's so much to keep telling you about God. I'm just asking you, settle it in your mind that God is God. When I rain for it doesn't know it God is God. Chris, did you see your defense? Are we not now? Or the postponement because of the rain? Have you done it after many years? Eh? 6 years. Somebody writing and postponing and delaying for 6 years. When he was telling me yesterday, I laughed inside me. Why? Because God said something about this month. And let me conclude with this. I am asking God that you will not miss the spectacular grace God is about to release again. See, let me tell you. Grace comes every time we gather to worship. But there are special grace, specific grace that God gives It doesn't come all the time. They are rare, but when they meet a man, a woman, it turns around everything. And God says, in this 6 months, that grace is going to come down again. Now, what does it mean that when this grace locates a person, it can turn their lives around? You see, some people's lives are changed, but they didn't know that it was this exceptional grace of God that came down on them that turned their lives around. They just discovered that, thank God, no, things don't be better for me. Why not my life? That was the grace. You see, this kind of grace is such that it doesn't even depend on your faith. It is a grace that comes as one of God's privilege for his children. When the Lord said to Mary about Elizabeth, your cousin Elizabeth is in her 6 months pregnant. 6 months. 6 months ago, that grace came down. 6 years ago, there was a grace. 6 months after, another exceptional grace came down. Mary, you are going to bring forth the Savior. And I am saying, this 6 months, that grace is coming again. Blessed are those who will be located. I don't know where, I don't know how, but I'm saying, prepare yourself for it. When Jesus met the man that has suffered for 38 years, and Jesus said, don't you want to be healed? He said, nobody they throw me some water. Every time there are specific women, the angel will come down and stir the water. The first people that will enter will be cured. That is exceptional grace. But this man could not make it for 38 years. And Jesus stood before him and said, that grace has come. Pick up your mat and go. That is the exceptional grace I'm talking about. He locates people. That's why I'm saying, look, you may be in a situation for years. Don't turn back. Don't give up. Don't surrender. Keep holding on to God. That exceptional grace will locate you. This is the grace God has declared for you this 6 months. It comes and it changes life. I pray that you may find this grace this 6 months. Stand to your feet. I want to say, you can't be talking about grace and grace and grace, but as pleased the Almighty to declare this 6 month, the month of June, by the blessing you are receiving and you will be receiving, he says that you are justified. By the blessing you are receiving, he said, you will be undeniably blessed. By the prayers you offer, the sacrifices you make, he says you will never lack. The exceptional grace that will bring divine touch upon your life. This month of June, this month, is the month for exceptional grace. Lord turn your life around.
Amen.
By the grace that is in you, may the Lord turn your situation around.
Amen.
Lord, I pray for your children that there will be exceptional grace that will locate them. Whatever the years the locusts have eaten, whatever the years the devourers have eaten out of you, by the power of the living God, you will find exceptional grace.
Thank you.
Thank you.
You
Apostles and prophets and Thank you.